Class 10. Today we discuss Class 10. Today we discuss the trigonometric identity. So what is trigonometric identity? An equation involving the trigonometric ratios. So let us summarize. Already in class 9 you studied the trigonometric ratios. So let us summarize trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric ratios. What is called trigonometric ratios? So all of you know this is a right angle triangle. Is it? So this angle is 90 degree. And set this angle is. So with respect to theta, we will name the three sides. So this is called hypotenuse, this is called the base or the adjacent side, and this one is called the altitude or opposite side. This is called opposite side. Opposite side. Or what you tell? Or perpendicular. This is called base or adjacent to the angle, so we say adjacent side. Okay. And this is called hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. So if we consider this angle, we have six trigonometric ratio, that is sine theta is perpendicular by hypotenuse, cos theta is base by hypotenuse, then tan theta is perpendicular by this. Then reciprocal of sine cosec. Cosec theta is reciprocal of sine, so we may write h by p. Then sec theta is b h by b, and cot theta is b by b. These are the six trigonometric ratios already in class 9 we studied. So today we will discuss the trigonometric identities involving these trigonometric ratios, that is sine, cos, all of this. There will be an equation, and that equation is called the trigonometric identity. And that equation is true for all values of angles. Say for example, let us say, what are trigonometric identities? Today we will discuss the trigonometric identities, and with the help of these trigonometric identities we will prove some proofs. Okay. So trigonometric identities. So what are trigonometric identities? Let us see. So number one, sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Number two, 1 plus tan square theta equal to sec square theta. Number three, 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosec square theta, or we have tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta, or and cot theta equal to cos theta by sin theta. So from 1 we may write theta plus cos square theta equal to what did I write? 1. So sin square theta is equal to, you may write 1 minus, transpose this term to the right side, 1 minus cos square theta. If you write cos square theta here, then transpose this sin square theta to the right side. So 1 minus sin square theta. Like this. These are some relations we may apply. Then second thing, from 1 plus sin square theta equal to sec square theta, then say we may transpose like this. 1 will be here, then transpose this tan square theta to right side, 1 minus sec square theta minus tan square theta, or we may write, what we may write? That is tan square theta minus sec square theta equal to minus 1. Transpose this minus 1 to that side. Then number 3, 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosec square theta. We may write, or we may write 1 equal to cosec square theta minus cos square theta, or we may write cos square theta minus cosec square theta equal to that 1 you transpose to the right side minus 1. So these are the relations. What we got? First, what are the identities? Number 1 is sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. 1 plus tan square theta is equal to always sec square theta. 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosec square theta. So tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. And cos theta is equal to cos theta by sin theta. Now, from this number 1, we may write, for our convenience, sometimes in place of sin square theta, we may put 1 minus cos square theta. In place of cos square theta, we may put 1 minus sin square according to the necessity of the question, if it is required in any question. So similarly, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. 1 is equal to sec square theta, transpose this tan square theta to the right side, minus tan square theta, or tan square theta you keep here, bring my sec square theta to the left side, plus become minus, equal to transpose the 1 to the right side, minus 1. Similarly, that is also same thing, 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosec square theta. 1 is keeping here, then cos square theta transpose to the right side, become minus cos square theta. Or cos square theta you keep here, bring cosec square theta to the left side, transpose it, then minus 1. So these are the important relations for doing the proofs of the identity. So you will be given some questions. Prove the some identities will be given, then we have to prove them. So by using this standard trigonometric identity. So now let us start one question, then you can understand. Prove the following identity. Prove that. If we ask, prove that. So the proof question is, prove that, say number 1 I am giving, number 1, 1 plus tan square A, angle is A here, 1 plus sin A whole into 1 minus sin A equal to what? 1. This is our question. We need to prove 1 plus tan square A whole into 1 plus sin A whole into 1 minus sin A equal to 1. So, to prove the trigonometric identity, plus b whole square. In factorial form. It will. Or sometimes a minus b to a minus b to a minus b whole square, like this. So this is also important for us. So in this question, prove that we ask that in this question ask that 1 plus 10 square a into 1 plus sin a into whole into 1 minus sin a is equal to 1. So in right side we should get 1 and left side these are the sum involving ratios, some relations are given to us. So at first let us take the left side because right side is already 1. So in left hand side, in equation, generally we always put, no, the left part is left hand side. This is the equal sign. And this is this side is the right side. So here, at first we have seen, let us see, right hand equation. At 1 plus sin a, whole into 1 minus. In this question, no doubt just now we discussed the identity. What we discussed? Say 1 plus 10 square a is equal to what we know? Sec square a. Since English, in place of theta it is a a. Okay, no doubt. 1 plus 10 square a is equal to sec square a. We will get the direct identity we can apply here. But in this question, you look 1 plus sin a whole into 1 minus sin a. How we can synthesize, make it small? Is it possible to make it small? What we can do? So if we compare with the algebraic identity, you have seen that say it is a plus say b. Is it? It is a minus. It is like this. What you have seen there, it is, if we consider what is a plus b and a minus b. So can we apply this identity? Okay, let us see. At first, let us apply and keep it like this at first. So why do we apply? Because we should have one we should get. Remember. So 1 plus 1 square, better to keep it like this. Then a square minus b square will be like a means what? 1. So a square is 1 square equal to 1. B square is what? B is equal to sin a. B square is what? Sin square. Is it? So we write 1 minus sin square. Okay. Now we see how we get 1. Is it very interesting? So 1 plus 10 square a, we know that 6 square a. Is it? That is it. Then 1 minus 10 square a, just now I give the relation to you. Sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to what? 1. Then cos square theta equal to what we write? 1 minus this sin square theta. So in place of theta there is a, you see. So in place of 1 minus sin square a, we can write cos square and here is sec square. But you may ask, why we write like this? Okay. Why you write like this? Because what trigonometric identity we got? Cos theta is equal to what will you get? B by h. Sec theta is equal to what will you get? H by b. Let us multiply. Cos theta into sec theta. Okay. Then b by h into h by b. B cancel, h cancel. What will you get? So if we multiply cos theta into sec theta, what will we get? 1. If we make it square, then it will be 1 square. 1 square is means what? 1. Is it? So in this question, substitute a, we write 6 square b. And 1 minus sin square a, in place of this we will write cos square a. Why? Because 6 square a into cos square a, we will get answer is 1. That's it. So, we will get the right side. So, now let us see. In place of 10, 1 plus 10 square a, we will write 6 square a into cos square. And if you are confusing, somebody may like write this also. In place of 1 by reciprocal of cos square a is equal to reciprocal of 6 square a, 1 by 6 square a is cancel. That is 1. So likewise, we will be given some relation and you need to remember the trigonometric identity at first. All of you should study the trigonometric identity, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, 1 plus cos square theta is equal to 6 square theta, and 1 plus cos square theta is equal to 6 square theta. These three identities, you should always study. You should remember, then only you can do the problem. So now let us see another question. Very simple. Say, same question, question number 2. Prove that
okay.
So likewise there will be some question. So we will do it, then you can solve it. Then next, let us see another question. So question number 3. Cosec A plus sin A. Cosec A plus sin A whole into cosec A minus sin A. Cosec A minus sin A equal to cot square A plus cos square. This is a revolution. So at first you see the left hand side will be cosec A plus sin A cosec A minus sin A. Very simple distribution is. Is it? A plus B, A minus. Is it? A plus B. And A minus. Next, A plus B, A minus B like that. So if we consider A plus B, A minus B, what we get? A square minus B square. A square minus B square. Okay. But right hand side, you look what you should get. Cot square A and cos square A. And we know the relation also. What relation you know? We know that cosec square A equal to what we can write? 1 plus cot square A. Is it? So cot will come. Then sin square A, we may write sin square A, what we know? From identity we know 1 minus cos square A. Is it? Cos will get. So let us apply this two. In place of cot square A, we write 1 plus cot square A. Minus, since minus sign is there, it would be better to give 1 bracket and put this. 1 minus cos square A. Then, what do you write? Remove the bracket. Minus 1, minus minus plus. Cos square A, 1 on cancel. Cos square A plus cos square A. This is our left right hand side. Is it? This is also. So, always you should know the identities very well and you have to apply it according to the equation. Next, let us do another question. Question is what? So let us see question number 3. We are doing 1, 2. We already did question number. So in this question, we asked what we asked. equal to, you should have 2 cosec 2 cosec. Now you take the left hand side, 10a by 1 plus second minus 10a by 1 minus second. So you may take directly LCM also or cosec A. Cosec A means what? You should get 1 by sin A. In right side, you should get like this value. You need 1 by sine. So, at first you take, you see, this is what? 10a by 1 plus sec a. Means 10a into 1. You mean, is it? So, better to like this. You take 10a common. Then there will be 1 by 1 plus sec a. Minus 1 by 1 minus sec. Then you take LCM. Okay. What do you get? 1 plus sec whole into 1 minus sec. Take the LCM. Then this and this will be cancelled. No? In exercise 3.1. Actually, we discussed now that rational expression simplification same thing. 1 by 1 plus second, by 1 plus second, 1 plus second, we can say 1 into this. What do you get? 1 into 1, 1 minus 1 into second, second. Minus, this and this is cancelled. 1 into 1 is 1. Okay. Then minus. What you get? 1 into second is. Then plus or minus 1 cancel. 10a you keep like this. Then minus second you write minus 2 second. And a plus b, a minus b you write 1 minus 6 square. Now 10a you keep here, minus 2 sec a you keep there, okay, minus 2 sec. Then you see, you know the identity, no? What identity you know? 1 plus sin square a is equal to what? 6 square a. Then 1 minus 6 square a you bring here, equal to what? Minus 10 square a. You see. You bring this 10 square a to right side become minus. So, in place of this, you may write minus 10 square a. Minus minus x. Okay? In bracket, you may write since 1 minus x square a equal to minus 10 square. So, by 10, 10 square is cancelled, only 10 a will get. So what we have? 2 sec a by 10 a. But still we are not getting our answer. Is it? So better to write in another form. We may use. How do we use? We know that sec a can be written as 1 by cos a and 10 a can be written as sin a by cos a. Sin a by cos a. You may ask me, why do you write like this? Why? Why you write like this? Because we need 2 cos a here. We don't need sec a 2 into sec a by 10 a. We should get the exact result. So how is this possible? So if we express sec a in terms of cos, so we may write 1 by cos a and sin a by cos a, then automatically cos a and cos a will be cancelled. We are having 1 by sin a. And 1 by sin a means what? We know cos a. because cosec A is equal to 1, reciprocal of sine. Okay. So in class 9 we discussed this relation. So now let's see how to write it. After that we'll write here no space. Better to write 1 by cos A by sin A by cos A. Next step, better to write like this. 2 into 1 by cos A, just the reciprocal of this, cos A by sin A. Better to multiply. Cos A also cancel. 2 into 1 by sin A. Is it? What we have? 1 by sin A. Equal to what you get? What do you get here? 2 cos A. Bracket you may write. Since 1 by sin A equal to cos A. So equal to what we have? Right hand side. That is. So like this, you have to do some questions. Later on again we will discuss some questions related to this chapter. Okay. We will discuss some important questions in this lesson.